Vodice.
We are currently in Vodice and just having a conversation over our coffee about how we feel like we're actually traveling now. It doesn't feel like a holiday anymore, does it? I feel like we're really settling into this way of life. And I mean, it's hard not to, isn't it, when you've got your coffee and you've got the marina and some islands over there. I also think we're at the perfect time of season. Like, there's no one else in these amazing restaurants, and there's just a few people walking through the streets, so everything's open.
Warm but not too hot.
Yeah, perfect, isn't it?
Yeah.
Heard about a trip over to the island over there, and there's a boat that goes every couple of hours, so we'll be getting that soon.
It's a boat and have a picnic and then pop back. Just pop to an island for a picnic.
Daddy's here.
Daddy's here. He's got the ticket. Think of our picnic spot then.
Good.
It's a good one, isn't it? Good for you.
My place is right where my mummy didn't want to sit.
Yeah, I didn't want to sit on the water. I wanted to sit closer to the water, didn't I?
Yeah, but if there's more view, there's no point. There's not really.
You don't think there's a view? Let's see what they think.
Cheapest accommodation in Croatia, but the guy's absolutely lovely running it. It's all family run. It's got everything we need. Feels massive after the caravan, down a little side street, not just all tourist accommodation. Yeah, it's good.
And we've literally got all of this on our doorstep as well, so there's a lot to explore straight from the front door.
Cheers!
Cheers, Amelia.
There's a lot more authentic. Yeah, cheers to that, Amelia Rose.
Here's our story. Subscribe for inspiration and escapism.
Vodice was the area we stayed in for the longest so far on our travels. And I think there's a few reasons for that. We instantly felt really settled here. It was without a car, it was really easy to access the town, the bakeries, the shops, and we started to become regulars in different places, which just had a really nice feel to it. As we walked in, everyone would say hi, and the bakery would throw us some free stuff, which was really, really nice. Didn't plan it very well, so we ended up having to move 3 times in the 3 weeks, but just like locally down the road, and we've got way too much stuff for just be moving around, so it's definitely something we're kind of reevaluating at the moment and thinking about the things that we just haven't really needed. I think when we packed, I kind of packed a bit like we were going on holiday, and we were really set on getting a car straight away, but we're finding there's something really nice about not having a car at the moment. One thing that's lovely about Vodice is the water's amazing. There's so many great swimming areas. We've really appreciated being able to go for a swim every day. That was a mosquito. Ow, itchy. You only want to do it if mommy does it?
Yeah.
Is that a deal?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, right.
I guess mommy's got to do it then. The thing we have to do is tell it. Something really nice about taking in the small things, not having to get out and do massive day trips every day. It's too much for us, and it's definitely too much for the children. So to just kind of stay still for a bit, have time to do stories and some of the things that we do at home, but also to do it in an environment where we can get up and go for a swim every day. It's really suited us. The harbour's lovely, the marina, and loads of different places to eat and get drinks, boat access to all the islands.
Where do we start? Yeah, and then we're going to sail down.
We would sail down, yeah.
Yeah, and then go through this canal to Shipnek.
Shipnek!
We're doing a lot of steps, aren't we?
Is he a boss? Can you see one of the steps?
goodness me.
After walking up all those steps, we decided we'd go into St. Michael's Fortress. So we're just about to go up here. And I'm thinking, what an incredible view. Making myself at home. Thought I could imagine myself here as a medieval princess. That was a really cool way to go through history, and I think we all got something out of that.
Spoiled for choice, really. Split, Vodice and Tregear were so stunning that I almost took for granted how nice Šibenik was. It's, you know, you got all these classic Croatian kind of narrow streets and little boutique shops and cafes.
We're travelling!
You are travelling, yeah. But I don't think you can beat this for an entrance to a city.
It's amazing. At sunset as well.
This canal through rocks. We're definitely looking forward to sailing here at some point.
What was your favourite thing about Šibenik?
We saw a cave on the boat.
Yeah.
And we might even see from here and have a story. Cave! But you can't. Movie! On a bridge! A dragon! A zombie!
That's a good zombie. What was your favourite thing today?
Spending time with our family. Like everything. I like the ice cream too much, so I needed to eat it all up by myself.
Are you going to go to sleep on the boat?
So, I'll do
say
it.
Say night-night.
Night-night. Good night. Good night.
There's also from here, there's buses that go even up to Zagreb and around. So we are moving today, and so I'm going to say goodbye to Vodice, but I think it's always going to have a really nice memory for us. We also had a friend come out and visit us here, so that made it feel even more homely. And onwards to our next place. At the moment, the plan is to stay there for 9 days, but who knows how long we'll stay. I think that's the really great thing about this, is just kind of going with how we feel at the time and doing what we feel at the, in the moment. And that was a massive part of why I wanted to do this, to figure out what it is that we wanted to do. And I think so far we've already figured out so many things about who we are as a family traveling, and what's actually really important to us, what's important to us with the accommodation, what's important to us with the location. And we're still figuring that out at the moment, and I think Croatia is the perfect country for doing that for us. Because we say pretty friendly, the exchange rate's pretty good, but we are moving, so goodbye to Vodice. If you haven't already, then subscribe. Every time someone subscribes, I literally do a happy dance, so please keep subscribing, and I will continue to make content about our travels. Also, do comment and let us know what you like about the videos and what you'd like to see more of. Wishing you a great day. Bye bye. Bye, Vodice.
Bye, Vodice. Bye, Vodice.